What is the ballsiest thing you've ever handed in as a project or assignment in school? In sophomore English, we had to memorize a work by an inspirational person. I went after people that did excerpts from MLK speeches and president's memoirs. I memorized There's a Wocket in My Pocket by Dr. Swiss. I don't remember my grade, but the looks on everyone's face will always remain with me. I don't know how you could get a bad grade on it. It's a work done by an inspirational person. Senior year of high school, a good friend of mine stood up in English class and recited the intro verse to Lose Yourself by Eminem in place of regular poetry we were supposed to be writing ourselves. Teacher thought it was about him wanting to be a stand-up comedian and loved it. I'm still amazed to this day how the class collectively kept it together. I copied some song that was playing on Much Music at the time for a poetry assignment. Teacher cried while reading it and thought I was suicidal and made me see the school counselor. Most fricked up part is I got a C because the imagery wasn't strong enough. B, it made you cry. So when I was in 7th grade, I played a ton of PS1 video games. Anyways, in my English class we were to do so many book reports on our choice of books. So instead of doing my reports on books, I did them on the video games I was playing, like FF7 and Resident Evil. It worked, they never seemed to notice. In our mythology class, we had to write our own myths related to what topics we were on. Creation, hero's journey, death, etc. My friends would just take video game or role-playing game stories and maybe change the names. One of my other friends would get so mad that they got the same grade as him after he spent hours writing his. In 9th grade art class, we had weeks to create a life-sized human art thing. Not really a statue, but not really a mannequin. Anyway, the point is, we fricked around for about 80% of the time, and were not even close to being done. We just had pieces of this dude all over the place. When it was time to present, we just threw them on the ground and said he got hit by a train. Teacher gave us an A. You could have saved yourself a lot of trouble by not turning anything in and saying he was on Malaysia Flight 370. I inserted a recipe for cookies into an essay for grade 12 law class. I suspected the teacher didn't read the middle bits, just the intro and conclusions. Suspicions were confirmed. I almost handed in an essay in second year university about Helen of Troy entitled Helen is a W, but that was an accident. I like to use fun working titles, and nearly forget to fix that one. I wrote a poem about jerking off for our senior year English assignment. Got a 86% on the assignment, but was asked not to read it aloud to the class when everyone else did theirs. You can't say that without telling us the poem. My senior research thesis was a 20-page term paper. It was supposed to cover the negatives of cigarettes and smoking. However, I didn't want to write a paper over the negative side of cigarettes, because that's boring. Side note, this teacher was terribly notorious for losing papers and covering it up with a fake grade. Over the course of a week after the due date, I convinced the teacher I had turned in my paper. I hadn't, and that I was extremely proud of it. I progressed to saying how eager I was for her feedback, and that I was ready to hear my grade. After a solid week, even staying after school to pester her, of incessant questioning, she tells me she finished my paper and that it was the most splendid piece of literature she'd ever had a student write. I got a 98. You know, I tried a few different approaches to term papers when I was in school, including out and out bulls, but I don't think gaslighting the teacher ever occurred to me. Capstone class for a sustainability program. There were only 9 of us. We all got really close, including our professor. We went on trips together, conventions, etc. It was a ton of work, but really interesting, and the crux of the class was that we all kind of made up the curriculum as we went according to what was most relevant in sustainability at the moment. We had a ton of literature to get through, so usually we would split up the readings and then discuss it at the beginning of class and fill each other in. So the week before the end of term, Prof decided to turn what was originally supposed to be a few pages of reflection into a 10-page paper on half of one of our books that we'd each only read a chapter or two of. We were all pretty strung out at this point, and with other classes and projects it was just not going to happen. So we're all emailing and calling one another, each trying to pull this one last paper out of our butt, and eventually one of us was just like, "Why don't we just not do it? She can't fail all of us. She won't." We knew we would all have to agree or it wouldn't work. After an hour or so of back and forth, we're all on board. Go into class on the last day to present our papers. She asks who wants to go first. We all look at each other and one of us just says, yeah, we didn't do it. It was way too much work with little notice, so we just decided as a group against it. She looks at us excitedly, I kid you not, and says, is this a mutiny? To which we replied, yes. She was impressed and we all got A's. She's still one of my best friends to this day. I went up intentionally unprepared to do a 10-minute verbal presentation on Lord of the Flies. My main point was, I'm struggling to give a presentation unprepared, so what would it be like to be stranded on an island unprepared? I got an A. Bravo, Lazebro. Was writing a final exam with different sections. Multiple choice, short answer, one sentence, long answer, paragraph, and essays. For each portion past the multiple choice, we only had to answer 3 or 4 out of the options given to us. If you answered anything more, they would go unmarked. So it's about halfway through the exam period and I make it to the essay portion. Only it's not labeled under essay, but says long answer, with the same description as the previous section. At the time I just wanted to go home. Thought I'd do terribly anyways on the section, so I left it blank. I hand the sucker in with no one batting an eyelash of a full section missing. Once I get home, my mom starts panicking that the school called. I didn't do the last year theater. So I think, well, okay, I already left, I can't do much, so why worry? Before even making it to class, when you all returned, the principal dragged me to the office where my teacher was waiting. She was there to tell me I failed because of leaving the biggest portion of the exam blank, and while the principal asked what was I thinking, so I told him the truth. He pulled out the exam and we looked over it. I explained I already did the portion, and in no way was there the word essay on any part of the exam. After a small chuckle, he remarked, he's not joking. You might want to go to class. I just need to finish talking to M's teacher. So I went back to class. A few minutes go by waiting for my teacher. She ends up being about 10 minutes late. She regretfully informs the class that their essay portion was omitted from their final exam grade because someone undermined the exam. So, I didn't do the longest portion, got a B, and was ignored by that teacher until I graduated. You were technically correct, the best kind of correct. We had to make some sort of artistic representation of the phrase never again in relation to the Holocaust. I decided to post extremely graphic picture of every genocide that had happened since the Holocaust and painted the phrase never again on top of it in my own blood. Got an A+, a spot in the display case, and a trip to the dean, the principal and the guidance counselor. I had an almost identical assignment. Mine was similar, but I'd used not my own dang blood. We had to write an argumentative paper for a college English class. Everyone wrote about things like abortion, medicinal marijuana, division of church and state. Basically very political arguments and serious topics. I argued that Seinfeld was the best sitcom of all time. Turns out when you end a paper with, yada yada yada, Seinfeld is the best sitcom of all time, and the teacher is a closet Seinfeld fanatic, you get an A+. Side note, the second paper, still everyone writing about serious things, I argued that Roger Federer is the greatest tennis player ever, because the teacher always had a racket in his backpack. I felt really good about those A+s. That's how it works. Literally nothing. I was an AP student in high school and was put into a group project for history with 2 students who did 0 work. We had a few weeks to put together a poster about some religion, and when the time came to present, we didn't have anything. If my group mates didn't want to do any work, I sure as heck wasn't going to do any to get them a grade. Total project was worth around 50 points. And the following week our teacher said we could get 1 point of extra credit for each can of non-perishable food we brought in. My parents took me to the dollar store and we purchased around 80 cans of food. Needless to say, there was a limit to how much extra credit you could get the following year. How the heck didn't the teacher think of that? Junior year we had to reenact the trial of Martin Luther for APMA. Everyone knew the outcome, so the guy who was picked to be the lawyer for Martin Luther used the full Chewbacca defense from South Park. Got himself a B+. If Chewbacca lives on Endor, you must acquit. My final paper for one of the last classes I need to graduate directly contradicted the professor's interpretation of a book that changed his life. I had to give an impromptu speech in class and all the topics had been written the night before and were given to 2 minutes before your time to start. My topic read, is it time for Jeb Bush to pull out of the race? He had pulled out the night before but the topic had been written and I guess the professor forgot. I stood up, read the topic, said he already did. Then I paused awkwardly for a few seconds and said please clap. I hope you got at least some laughs for please clap. It was actually my best friend back when we were in high school earth science. 15% of our overall class grade was to do a presentation about anyone who's made significant contributions to the field of earth science and astronomy. I, being the science nerd, made my presentation about Kepler. My friend's presentation was about Billy D. Williams. The first slide was a portrait of Lando Calrissian. The rest of the presentation was 10 minutes of Lando's activities in The Empire Strikes Back, ending with a video clip of scenes where he flirts with Leia. My presentation got a B. My friend got a freaking A. Granted, our earth science teacher was a car mechanic for 20 years before being a teacher. We're still not sure what her credentials for teaching that class really were. This was 12 years ago. I still give my friend crap about it. A hospital bed and an electronic counter. In high school in our senior year we have to do this huge project on anything we want. We start at the end of our junior year preparing for it. You have to do a presentation, essay and present it in front of the school. One kid in my class did his on HIV AIDS. He got the bed from the local hospital. For the whole week he placed it on the stage. Behind it was the counter and it counted non-stop. His day to present his project was on the last day. No one knew what it was on. Now the bed and counter were there when others were doing theirs. He went onto the stage and pointed to the counter and said that's how many people died this week of HIV and AIDS. And he walked off. Not ballsy to some but it was in its own way. Given how much effort you were supposed to put into it and it was very powerful. Although powerful on its own. And it certainly did take some effort to actually get a bed and a counter for a week. It still seems like a pretty lazy presentation. I feel like that would have been a very powerful attention-grabbing tool at the start of a presentation. And he could have gone on to talk about HIV/AIDS more. One time I cited a website that I had created in a paper. Also one time in middle school I was supposed to do a book report on Bridge to Terabithia and I only read a few chapters and winged it. I wrote about how happy the book was since the kids had made up this fantasy world. If you have been too busy for the last 37 years to read Bridge to Terabithia, then spoilers, it's not a happy book. A little girl dies. My teacher had words with me. In grade 12 I didn't want to read a book of my choice for a book report so I just found some random book and made up my own story and own quotes from the book to fit what I needed to include in my paper. I got a B. I was talking to a couple friends in chemistry class about guar instead of doing work, but my teacher asked us what we're talking about. I was honest. Guar. She replied, like, guar gum we said. Yes. Guar gum. She assigned us a presentation on the topic. We made up the presentation at lunch on the day of the report. Total balls. Like, guar gum. Derived from the guarensis rickettsia tree. Was discovered by chemist Hyman Roth in New Guinea in 1912. The presentation lasted about 10 minutes. And she knew it was balls. But she was as weird as us and probably appreciated the comedy of the situation and the story it would provide at dinner that night. So that's how Roth made his fortune. And I was thinking it had something to do with mafia. In my senior year of high school I had to retake an English course from my freshman year. It was a relatively easy course for my level at the time, except for the final project. The final project was an unnecessarily long 8-page study report on someone we considered a hero, including a 4-page essay and detailed PowerPoint. It was 2012, and the release of Skyrim kept all of this from happening. So the night before my PowerPoint presentation, not done at all, was scheduled, I threw my Hail Mary. I pulled the project from my freshman year out of the archives of my laptop, without really looking at it. But due to my overconfidence and ignorance, I freaking forgot that this was the project that actually failed me in freshman year. So when I got up in front of the projector and finally realized my fatal mistake, it was too late. Projected on the white canvas behind me, a childlike mishmash of poorly chosen clip art and slide transitions dedicated to the lead singer of My Chemical Romance. Gerard Way. I felt everything in my body begin to die. I felt 30 pairs of eyes drill intense judgment into my skull. I felt shame. I couldn't escape it, so I just ran with it. For 5 minutes I improvised the most passionately spoken, crap-filled speech straight out of my butt. I told of how his music gave hope and joy to kids all over the country, how he cared about all of his fans, and how he broke through the wall that was the punk stereotype. Final grade 195/200 points. I missed the points because I forgot to cite one of my sources in my essay. Teacher's note, shows improvement. I had an assignment to turn in about the government and news related for class, and it was right before Christmas break. What I turned in was a 5-page essay on the spirit of Christmas. I got an A+. I don't know if it really hit her in the feels or something, but it worked. In my Greek mythology class, we were given an assignment to write a 2,500-word essay on one famous Greek figure in their mythology and how they affected Greek life. In my gender studies class, we had to write a 2,500-word essay about an oppressed woman and how she changed the world she lived in. I wrote an essay about Pandora and how her story created the misogynistic worldview of ancient Greece. 2 assignments. 1 essay. For both of them. You had an unimaginative gender studies professor. Our assignment. Write an essay on a travesty and how it could have been avoided. My essay's opening paragraph. Many teachers have attempted to squash my thirst for original thought. I thought I was going to make it out of college with my creativity still firmly in place. That was until I met a professor named. This is where I named the professor of this class. The rest of the essay goes on to describe how this professor successfully strived me of all my original thoughts. My essay's grade, A. Wrote a short story about a cop who was under investigation for police brutality. One night on the job he hesitated and was killed by an armed suspect. I got a good grade. But I had to read it out loud to the class followed by a Q&A. The class was not happy. We had to make a webpage on any topic. So I picked flesh-eating viruses complete with gruesome pictures. Teacher's comment, after spitting out my tea and getting my composure, B+. In my consumer economics class, a required course to graduate, I had a rather lazy teacher. He would barely flip through our assignments and pass them back at the end of class and everyone got 100s. Now I know it's cool that we all got 100s, but I went to a high school where many teachers make 6 figures, so it bothered me that he put no effort into his job. So he assigned a project where we were supposed to arrange a meeting with a financial planner and discuss our future. That was it. No other specifics. So I decided I wasn't going to do it and instead write a bullcrap paper of the specified length and see if he would notice. The first paragraph was kosher, but the rest of it was about my magical experience at the bank where I walked in and leprechauns handed me sacks of gold and I rode around on a unicorn and said things like, "I know you're not reading this, mister. Dot." I think I wrote about 3 pages of that. Turned it in and got a 100. After I graduated I sent him an email with the paper I turned in and he was needless to say pretty peed about it. He even confronted me about it when I returned to the school and tried to lecture me about how I missed out on the opportunity to learn. I looked him straight in the face and said, "Sorry mister, you had a whole year to teach me, but you missed the opportunity. Was it passive-aggressive, risky, and childish?" "Yes, but I became somewhat of a legend for it. I went back maybe 5 years later to see some old coaches and track practice. The coach introduced me to the guys and one of them asked, "Are you the one who wrote that paper about the leprechauns and got 100 on it?" I knew a guy who once took a few hits of acid and wrote a paper for English in grade 11. He handed it in. When confronted, the teacher asked him, "What the frick is this?" and he responded, "You're the teacher. You figure it out." Apparently it started with words, then unknown symbols and morphed into scribbles and drawings and smudges. This mouse is looking for friends in the comments. Comment mouse boy to befriend him. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.